What's up everyone, welcome back to the channel, and in this video I'll show you how to install ReDriver 2, the unofficial PC port of the classic PS1 game. This is the best way to experience the game now, as it brings several quality of life upgrades: stable frame rate, bug fixing, high resolution support, increased draw distance, and more. And it even comes with a debug menu with cheats that you can play with. If you're planning on buying on Amazon, please use my affiliate link below in the description. Any product on the website will count and you will be directly supporting the channel. So this project is available here on this page of GitHub. I'll drop the link on the description of the video. And right here under releases, you're gonna click on the latest version available for this PC port. It should take you to a page like this one. And you're gonna scroll down under assets. And the file you're gonna download is this one, ReDriver 2 Win32 Release Dev.zip. So go ahead and click on this one to download the file. Second, you're gonna need Java runtime. The link will also be in the description, and on this page, click on this download button to get the file on your PC as well. We'll install that later. Lastly, we'll also need Visual C++. Link will also be in the description. Scrolling down a bit here, you see that we have the x86 and 64 options. If your PC has up to 4 GB of RAM memory, you're gonna get the x86 version. If it has more than 4 GB, then download the x64 version. Put this on the same folder as well for later. Okay, so now I have all three files with me, and we're gonna start by installing the Java runtime, this one here. Double click on this file. It's gonna bring up this window, so you're gonna go ahead and click on install. Just wait until it's finished, should only take a few seconds or so. And once it's done, you're gonna see this message here. Now click on close. Next, we're gonna install the VC++. So once again, double click on this file. It will bring up to this window. Click here where it says I accept the terms and stuff like that. Click on install, and there you go. If you already have this file here on your PC, the program will tell you. If you played games on your PC before, that is, it's likely that you already have this with you. But regardless if you have that installed previously or not, you're gonna see this window right here. And it's asking you to restart the PC, but you don't really need to do this. So now click on close, and now let's start with the ReDriver 2 files. So this file is a zip one, and you're gonna have to extract this with WinRAR or 7-zip or the extracting tool if you are on Windows 11. I'm gonna personally recommend you to use 7-zip. I'll put the link of that on the description of this video, so download and install that. And once you're done, you're gonna right click on this file. You're gonna select WinRAR or 7-zip, depending on what you have. And then you're gonna click on extract here. Should only take a few seconds or so, and there you go. From this point on, you can delete the original zip file and also the VC++ and the Java runtime file as well. We're not gonna need this anymore. Now, at this point, you're gonna need the PlayStation 1 disk files for driver 2, that is CD1 and 2. I have both disks here on the bin format for the CD1 and 2, but if you have the game on the ISO format, it will work as well. And you're gonna have to find these game files on your own. Now, on the same folder with everything, you're gonna double click here on this launcher application, and this window will show up. From here, you're gonna click on Setup Wizard to bring up this window. Now, right here under CD1 image, this is where the CD1 file of the game will be, of course. So you're gonna click here on this choose button, and it's gonna open up this window. By default, it's opening the same folder where the files are. And you can already see here the CD1 and 2 for the game. So now, you're gonna locate CD1 and double click on this. So it brings up to this window. Now you're gonna do the exact same thing for CD2. Select choose on the window, double click on driver2 cd2.bin or the ISO depending on what you have. Now make sure these two are enabled, and now you're just gonna click on install. This window will pop up, select OK, this one as well, select OK, and now you're gonna see this CMD window showing up. It is now doing the conversion of the game to the unofficial PC port, that is. This should only take a minute or so to finish, so now you just have to wait. this would be a good time to subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video. Once it's done, you're gonna see this window, so click on OK, and this part is finished. At this point, you can go ahead and delete the original bin files because the game files are now going to be inside one of these folders here. I think it's this one. But either way, you can delete that if you want. Now let's tweak the settings here that we have for this port. Right here on the same driver to PC window, you're gonna click on Configure to bring up a few of the options you have here. First off, you can play this game on PC now with your keyboard or with a controller, that is a PlayStation or Xbox controller or even some third-party controllers too. And if you want to change the inputs, you're just gonna click on controller or a keyboard, and here you can see the inputs of your game. So if you want to change any button here, you just have to click on the action and then press that respective button on your controller, like this one. Same thing for the keyboard as well. Next, we have some graphical options here. Keep everything enabled, and we can also run the game in full screen whenever you start. If you want to have that on, just click on this window and we are done here. Now, there are some additional settings that don't show up in here. Instead, they are inside this config file on the driver 2 folder. You can just open this by double clicking on this file. It's gonna open with Notepad, but if for some reason this is not opening up for you, you're gonna right click this file, select open with, and then you might see Notepad here. But if it doesn't show up, click on choose another app, and you're gonna have to locate it here under more apps. Either way, inside this config file, like I said, we have the same controller and keyboard options too, but on the bottom, we have some render and game settings too. Even if you choose the enable gaming full screen option, by default, this is going to run at 720p resolution. So the game will not fill the entire screen if you have a monitor with a higher resolution than this one. For example, in my case, I'm using a 1080p option, so it's 1920 by 1080. If you have one as well, you have to change the values here on screen width and high. And all you gotta do here is just delete the 1280 and replace it with 1920. And on the height, you type 1080. That is the 1080p resolution. So if you have a 1440p monitor or even 4K, you just have to type in the resolution here. This unofficial port has support for 4K resolution, so you can change it in here just as fine. We also have the VSync option, which by default is set to 1. This prevents screen tearing, but it can introduce a bit of input latency, but at least on this game, I didn't notice any difference here, but if you want to change this, go ahead and type 0 in here to have that off. And right on game, we have the language settings. By default, this is set to English, right here where it says number 0. So if you want to change the game to, for example, the French language, that is number 3 in here. So you just have to change the respective button as such. Pretty straightforward, right? And then some extra options in here, but a lot of these can be done in game. Once you've done the changes here, don't forget to save. Click on File and then save, or you can press Ctrl S on your keyboard. Also, one thing I noticed on this port is that after you change your settings in here, if you open the launcher again, and if you change any of the settings here and select save and close, it will reset the changes you've made on the config file. So just remember that. If you make any changes in here, go back to the config file and make sure that they are in the way that you set them before. That's it for the configuration. To start your game, you can either double click on this ReDriver 2 dev file, or you can double click the launcher and open the game from clicking on launch game. That's gonna be up to you. There's no difference to that. I'm gonna open it from here, click on this button, and the game is going to start as such. If you want to enable dev mode on the game, you just have to press start, and you're gonna see the options right here. So you can just play with these cheats the way you want. I have many videos like this showing you how to install games on PC with the best settings for graphics and performance. So if you like what you saw, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, leave a like on this video, and check out my other stuff. Thank you for watching, and as always, I'll see you soon.